G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, we're just going to keep going with the estimating sheets. And we're actually going to do an item. We're going to work out the concrete for this little slab and the strip footing. So the first thing I'm going to do is I've got to put a row in above this heading. So I'm just going to select on that row there and then right click and go insert one above. So we have a new row above. And I'm going to call that the trade, because we're going to have a sheet for every trade. So I'm just going to put trade there, and then over here I'm going to go concreter. Okay, and you'll see when I click out of that, it's cut it off, and that's because it doesn't fit into this little cell, or the B column. So what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to select a couple of columns or a couple of those cells, and I'm going to hit the merge. And that'll bring it up so it's in full text, okay? So then when we do our estimating sheets, the first row is where we put our description of our job. So we have to label them as well, so we're going to tell which description we're talking about. So I'm going to call this A, and you'll notice that's already come up centered. So you know, if you want to center it or move it around, you can justify it. Right justify it, left justify it, or center justify it. Okay, and that'll do it for the cell. If you want to do the whole column, select the column and do the same thing. Okay, that'll move everything over in the whole column. Okay, so next thing, in the particulars column, I want to write a description. And so I'm going to write, I'm just going to select all those cells in there, and I'm going to merge them all together so my description fits. And I've already written it. I'll just cut and paste it into there. So this is pretty easy. My description is not that long. We're just doing 30 MPA concrete to slab and strip footing. Okay, but you could have more information like, you know, direct poured from truck, you know, or, you know, pumped, you know, whatever the delivery method has to be. You could have more information in there. If you got to a point where the actual text was running off the page, and what I'll do, I'll just keep cutting and pasting this in here until that happens. Okay, so see how that's gone past the end of the cell, and it's cut it off. So what you can do is you can just select that cell and go up here to text wrapping and just go to the wrap item, the wrap symbol, and select that. So that wraps the word back onto the next line. Makes our cell bigger, and we're all good to go. Okay, I'm just going to make this a bit smaller so it's not taking up too much space. Okay, so we've got our description in. So then we want to, firstly, let's do the volume of our slab. So we'll just put a little heading up here. So this area here is going to be for the slab, and we'll do the slab volume all in one hit. Okay, I'll make that a capital. Okay, so the volume is obviously the length times the width times the thickness. So the length of our slab is 10.2 meters long. It's, we're going to times, so I always put a times symbol in there. It's 6.3 meters wide. And times the thickness of the slab, which in this case is 110 mil, so 0.110. Okay, that's got italics on it, but I don't want that, so I'll take that off. Okay, so see how some of them have come up with three decimal places, some haven't. You can change that around by using this one here, increase or decrease the decimal points. So if I want three decimal places, I just hit that two more times, that one's all right. This one, I need an extra one, so just increase. So I've now got all those figures showing me three decimal places. So then I want to equal this. So I'm just going to, if I just type equals with sheets and Excel, it thinks you want to do a formula. So it actually brings up this little tab, and it does all sorts of weird stuff if you keep going. So the easiest way to do an equal sign is just hit the shift key, sorry, the space key first, and then the equal symbol, and you'll just get the equal symbol, okay? So I put this, I just put these in so I know what the calculations are actually doing. I'm not using these to calculate. It's just there so I know what I've done. So over here, I'm going to do that whole calculation in one hit. So I've got my, I'm going to select where I want my answer to appear. I'm going to hit the equals sign, and that little symbol comes up. And then I'm going to select the first cell that I want to put in my sum. So the 10.2. And see how here it comes up with D5, which is column D, row 5. And it tells me 10.2 will be the total answer. Okay. To multiply with sheets and Excel, you just hit the star symbol. And then you're going to select the next cell that you want to include in that calculation. And then I want to times again, so the star symbol and the next cell. And once I've got all the cells in there that I need, I'm just going to hit equals and that will give me my answer. So that's actually to four decimal places. So I'm just going to decrease my decimal places and I'll get my answer to four decimal places. And I'm going to make that into italics just so it stands out a bit. So that is the volume for the slab. In the next video, I'll show you how to do the volume for the actual footing. G'day, I'm back. Just to let you know that if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or you can follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.